First off, is the first all-electric airline with Harbor Air using Magna X 750 horse electric engines. These are supposed to be used as commuter planes between Vancouver and Seattle and other locales, and I can see promise that these things could be used in other markets as well. Next is self-charging pacemakers. See, one of the problems we've got with a lot of our technologies are batteries, but it turns out scientists have come up with a way that we can use our own heartbeat to generate enough electricity to run equipment, including pacemakers, meaning we don't have to have surgery done again on that. Pretty interesting stuff. From a 3D printing perspective, we've taught you in the past there's four methodologies for 3D printing, but this year they became a fifth one called volumetric printing. Now this is interesting because you can create a 3D solid in about 30 seconds with this approach. Now some of the 3D solids that are being created, I don't know. Have you had one of the meat substitute burgers so far, Impossible Foods or Beyond Meat or Nestle's? You know, one of these is public at this point, and you're gonna see a lot more of these veggie substitute type of products coming along. But this one, this next one is the one that really caught my eye. This is from Wageningen University, Ots-John van der Goot, basically uses a device there at the bottom called the Couette Cell. And what they're doing is they're printing steaks, all right? And they're trying to make them act like a fillet, but they're all vegetarian-based. And they're getting pretty good at printing these steaks with these combinations of protein and water and gluten, and they're making good progress on it and so forth. Well, 3D printed homes, as I said before, are pretty common, but I want you to see the picture of this property, 400 square meters, all printed with 20 tons of C30 grade concrete, 250 millimeters thick. Its testing suggests it can withstand Richter 8.0 earthquakes. Pretty good little structure. Took 45 days to print this building. Now, in New York City, the Domino Tower in Brooklyn was printed with 3D printers as well, which is another thing that many of you might have missed along the way. We just went through the Indy 500, and I want you to understand those carbon fiber race cars are very sophisticated pieces of equipment. It turns out that you can knit sport cars, and it turns out that Bertha, the knitting machine, is being set up to begin knitting regular commercial automobiles.